Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to introduce the D1 Mini Development Board based on ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. I'm going to show you how to install the driver, prepare your Arduino so you can start programming. First, we will run a simple blink code to blink an LED. Then we select different pins to blink an LED. After that, you will learn about pin mapping so you can easily use the pins. Then we will use this module as HTTP client, meaning that we will send a request to a web page and retrieve the information from the web. You can get the code, library, and driver by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. With the introduction of ESP8265 and 66 and the subsequent other versions of this module, the Internet of Things have been revolutionized. A lot of devices from small to large, they can be connected, meaning that we can control devices over the Wi-Fi from across the world or within the network. And this module, with the price and size and capability, makes it suitable for a lot of applications. The module is such that you can start using it within Arduino IDE or Arduino environment program with a familiar code that you write. At the back end, it will be compiled using Python and other methods to be uploaded to the device. But without further ado, here is the device. And this is the D1 Mini module. When you receive it, they ship it with three types of headers. One is this long one, if you want to stack it on the other devices, so you have this long header with long pins. And this side is female, so you can insert other item on top of it. The other one is the male-female short without extended pin. And the third one is the regular male header, like this. I'm going to solder this because I might need to connect different devices, and this will make it easy for me. You are selecting the side, which side to solder. Make sure to select the side that matches this. For example, here, when I hold this, I see, for example, here the 5 is here, 5 volts, and TX is in here. So I have to see that 5 volts and TX is here. I can put my header here. If you try it this way, the 5 volts will not be here, while the 5 volts is on the other side, and it will not work. Now this has been soldered. There are different variations of it. Do not worry about it. Once you bought it, it has a 4 megabyte of RAM, and these are the pins, all the specification. Operating voltage is 3.3 volts, but we will feed in 5 volts to it, and it has a regulator built in. The frequency is either, it works 80 or 160 megahertz. The software was selected. And using that data, I've drawn this. I put all the data accordingly. The pins have been labeled as 5 volts ground, D1, D2, 3, and RX, TX. These are for serial port communication. And 3.3 volts, D8, 7, 6, 5, 0, analog 0. We have only one analog, but it has limitation of 3.2 volts maximum. This is the reset pin that if you want to reset it via the software. And if you want to use I2C communication, these two pins, D1, D2, are SCL and SDA. And if you want to use SPI communication, these pins are for SPI communication. The module has a micro USB and reset button. The USB is based on CH340C. This is very famous and common. I have the driver for this in case if you have problem with this. I will also provide you the link. Your module looks like this, or if it looks like this, doesn't matter, because this is the same chip that you see here, and this is a crystal oscillator for this, 26 megahertz. This has no shielding, metal shielding, and here is a metal shielding. and by adding those variations, they just change the name. So this is exactly the same module, either on this one, or on this one, or on this one. You might have different amount of RAM, and you might have different amount of pins, but for this purpose, for basic applications, it's exactly the same. If you have not used ESP8266 Wi-Fi module before, first copy this line here. I will provide you in the description. Copy this by clicking right click copy or Control C. Then in your Arduino, click on File, Preferences, and this line, as you can see, open it, and whatever you have before, just enter and Control V, paste it. So this is the line that I have already pasted. Then click OK and click OK. After that, click on Tools, Board Manager. Wait until you can type something here because it's reading all the data. And then type ESP8266. Wait. In my case, it shows installed. In your case, you will see an install here. Click Install and wait. You will see the bar graph here until the installation is finished, and then close this. And this is a blink. You can open it by clicking at the File, Examples, ESP8266, blink. And what I've done is I've made this to be a little interesting. It blinks multiple times, shorter and then longer at the end. The first one, it says low. In this module, this LED is low trigger, which means when you send low, it is on, and when you send high, it is off. So I have set it for 300 milliseconds on and 300 milliseconds off. Then on and off and off. At the end, we have 1000 milliseconds on, 1000 milliseconds off. And if you look here, built-in LED is D4. Pay attention here, it says built-in LED, not LED built-in. Let's try built-in LED. Now let's upload it. And as you can see, it's uploaded without any issue. So built-in LED or LED built-in, both of them are working the same way. Now here I've connected an LED with a resistor with two wires. So this is the negative. I'm gonna connect it to the ground. And as you can see, built-in LED is at pin D4. I'm connecting this to D4, which is this pin. And pay attention here, these two are the opposite of each other. As I mentioned, this is low trigger. With low, this is on, and with the low, this is off. As you can see, when that is on, this is off. So the pin is proper, low is low, high is high, but this LED is the opposite, so keep that in mind. Now let's turn on the LED using the D0. As you can see, D0 is pin 16, so we can replace this with 16. So I've replaced them all with 16. Let me upload it. Now this LED is running with the D0, the pin D0, which is pin 16. And here, this is the mapping constants, which I took it from GitHub website, which is for this ESP8266. I just copied and pasted. You can copy and paste it, so it, in every program that you have, it will be just easy to use. They have been all mapped properly, you don't have to worry, and this is how they have been labeled on the pen, and you just need to use the proper D, and that, for example, D1 means 5. You don't have to worry about 5, just put D1 and connect your wire to D1. Now I'm going to D7 and LED pen, let's call it D7 and upload it. As you can see, it's working. So I will provide you with this code. Now let's test this as an HTTP client, meaning we can request a page with this device. Go to File, Example, and you see HTTP client and basic HTTP client. You don't need to include anything. These are all included with the driver that I just shown you. The only thing that you need to pay attention is this baud rate. When you open the serial monitor, it must match. And SSID, this is the Wi-Fi name. And then this is the password that you have to put. So what this code does is it goes to this page and it requests information from this page. And now let me show you. This is a text, and behind the scene, actually, this is the whole text up to here. Without this, this is my antivirus, but the rest is the response from this page. Get my own page. Here I've created this. Welcome to Robojax.com. This is a test for the D1 Mini, and this is a code for this in HTML. The browser shows it that way. And this is a code. Arduino serial monitor will display it like this. I've replaced the code and I've uploaded it. Let me open it. So this is the text that we got. And this is my code here. And this is the text that we received from here, from HTML up to here. This is the exact code that my website has responded. So what is the beauty of this? You can actually, this is a request, which means it goes to this page and it says, give me information. But you can send a data here. For example, you can have a page that accepts information, and you can have question mark, temperature 1 equal 87.2 or something. So you can send the temperature from your Arduino, from this environment, and put it here. This will go to that server and it will be recorded, and server will respond back, not the page that I've shown you like this. It might just reply okay, or maybe it replied the record number or ID number that the temperature have been recorded. And you can find your own way to do many other fancy things with it. I would like to sincerely thank the following people who have supported me via Patreon. Thank you for watching. This was introduction to D1 Mini development board Wi-Fi module. If you learned something and like this video, please thumb up, as this will help in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. If you subscribe to my channel, you get updates of my upcoming videos.